What is sedition? Is the sedition law being misused and abused in India? Let's find out. Congress leader Shashi Tharoor, senior journalist Rajdeep Sardesai, and five other journalists such as Mirinal Pandey, Vinod Jose, Zafar Agha, Paresh Nath and Anant Nath were booked for sedition by Noida police on January 20th for misleading tweets on farmer's death. Another FIR was lodged by Delhi police on January 30th. The FIR said that they had shared misinformation and instigated violence on January 26th. In UP, the FIR was lodged under IPC sections 124A sedition, 153A promoting enmity between different groups on grounds of religion and others. As per reports, so far, FIRs have been registered in 5 states against Shashi Tharoor and 6 other journalists for their allegedly misleading tweets on the violence and death of a protester during the farmers' tractor rally in Delhi on Republic Day. And as I told you, most of the FIRs invoke IPC sections of sedition, criminal intimidation, promoting enmity, criminal conspiracy, and outraging religious feelings, among others. After all these cases and other recent matters related to sedition charges in the country, a debate has started on the sedition law once again. So what's sedition law? Section 124A of the Indian Penal Code IPC talks about sedition. It was drafted by Thomas Bovington Macaulay and was included in the IPC in 1870. The sedition law is more than 150 years old in India, and the irony is that the United Kingdom, from where the law originated, has abolished it. But here in India, it is still in operation. In pre-independent India, the British had used this law to suppress freedom movements, and leaders like Mahatma Gandhi and Bal Gangadhar Tilak had to even go to jail under this law. What does Section 124A say? Section 124A deals with words, signals, or visual representation that brings or attempts to bring into hatred or contempt or excites disaffection against the government established by law in India. What is the punishment under Section 124A? Reports suggest that sedition is a non-bailable offense, and punishment under the law varies from imprisonment up to 3 years to imprisonment for life and fine. What have leaders like Mahatma Gandhi and Jawaharlal Nehru said about sedition? As per reports, when Mahatma Gandhi was charged under Section 124A, he called it the prince among the political sections of the IPC designed to suppress the liberty of the citizen. Jawaharlal Nehru also criticized the sedition law. In 1951, Jawaharlal Nehru had famously said, "Now, so far as I am concerned, that particular Section 124A IPC is highly objectionable and obnoxious, and it should have no place both for practical and historical reasons, if you like, in any body of laws that we might pass." He also said, "The sooner we get rid of it, the better." Now the question is this: has the use of sedition increased in India in the recent times? Let's see and understand. Article 14 report reveals that 65% of nearly 11,000 individuals in 816 sedition cases since 2010 were implicated after 2014, when Modi took office. And do you know who these people were charged with sedition? There were leaders from opposition parties, students, journalists, authors, and academics. The report further says that 96% of sedition cases filed against 405 Indians for criticizing politicians and government over the last decade were registered after 2014. As per the same report, there was an increase of 28% in the number of sedition cases filed each year between 2014 and 2020 when compared to the yearly average between 2010 and 2014. So is the law being abused? Justice Madan Lokur, a former judge of the Supreme Court, said, "It is now clear from these data that the law is not being misused, but it is being abused."